Hey guys, my name is Jeppe Tengbjerg and I am the founder of the International Massage Association and I am the CEO of the World Championship in Massage. I'm very, very sorry that I cannot participate in the Swiss Massage Championship as well as the Wellness Congress, but the situation in Denmark is chaotic actually because of all this virus thing. So I'm standing here in my garden telling you a little bit about massage trends. But first, a little bit about the World Championship in Copenhagen. We have had this championship 3 times and this year we will have the 4th. And the World Championship in massage is made to inspire each other, sharing skills and to network. Have a look at this little teaser.
What makes the World Championship so special is the family, the camaraderie. Coming here year after year and just coming home to a family feels really good.
World Championship in massage is a great event because you will see so many different kinds of methods and there is inspiration for everybody.
So now everybody, please enjoy us. Come to Copenhagen, come to World Championship. You've been a star, you will be a star, and you will take new techniques of massage. You see lots of things.
My stomach is crumbling, so a lot of emotions on me, a lot of people congratulate me, I feel overwhelming.
Happy. This is the triumph of the whole country of Thailand.
Hello Copenhagen, I'm from Sri Lanka. Hope to see you next year.
So the World Championship is many things. One of the great things about the World Championship and championships in general is that you can find inspiration and see different methods you might not have seen before. This is an example from the American Travis Knut from 2018.
It comes from a very gentle version of acrobatic yoga. So using the weight of their body with gravity to create a lot of traction along the spine, to create some inversions, to get some blood running to new areas of the body, and to kind of flip their world upside down for a little bit. I had a teacher who told me that every time you give a session, you receive a session. So I always make it a goal to receive a session every time I give, so that way not only is it a healing experience for my client, we can experience that together. It just goes to show that hard work and effort continuously every day will give you rewards. You know, no matter what they are, if you put in the effort, you'll get the rewards.
Travis Knut, this acrobatic yoga massage is of course not for everybody. And it's not only that massage should be a show. Good massage is really three things in my opinion. It is the treatment itself. Doesn't matter what kind of method it is really, but the treatment itself, and it's about wellness, and it's about the experience. And if you can combine those three things, you have world class. World class had Konstantina from Greece in 2018. She became the world champion overall, and she was actually giving Swedish massage. You can see a little film with her here.
I'm amazed, you know, everybody is so good, so difficult to compete. Oh my goodness. So you have to work hard. And be, you know, to be inside from the, your bottom of your heart, this is the secret. Just give it all and be concentrated to your client, no matter what.
I'm here because I am going to tell you a little bit about massage trends. How is massage developing in the world? New methods, styles, and so on. We saw so many things these last 3 years at the World Championship. Actually, the last championship had 200 participants from 42 different countries. So we really could see how massage is developing. Let me begin with something else. Actually, a survey from the massage magazine, the American magazine, Massage Magazine, they took back in 2018, they made a survey about the top five classes. Actually, it was top 10, but let's say the top five. And the top five was myofascial release, which was not brand new, but it was the most wanted class. It was stretching, and then deep tissue massage, and kinesiotaping, you know, this elastic taping kind of thing, and it was medical massage. So those five were the most wanted in America at that time. But now, actually, it is developing a little bit. At the World Championship, it has been Thai massage, which has been incredible, starting with Nari winning the 2017 edition with her Thai Warrior massage. And since 2019, in December, Thai massage actually came onto UNESCO's heritage list, which is amazing. But what we see now is that everybody is combining different kind of methods. It could be massage combined with Lomi Lomi, for example. Lomi Lomi is this Hawaiian massage, and especially Americans are doing that, but most people are now doing the combination between mobilization and massage, of course, and then the stretching in different versions, different styles and methods. That's what we really see in Denmark at the World Championship, and we call it freestyle massage, this category itself. I would like to encourage you to participate at the World Championship in Massage in order for you to get inspired and to come and share your skills with the other participants. This last film is a little film for you to find inspiration. It's made by the French. It's approximately 10 minutes long and has a lot of beautiful massage therapists doing a lot of different methods, and it's a very wonderful film. I hope you will find the inspiration, and hopefully I will see you out there in the massage world.
It is the third time we are having this World Championship in massage. We have seen so much quality. And people are happy, there are good vibes and a good atmosphere. Welcome. We are having 200 participants from 42 different countries, and it's still growing. Massage has different purposes. For some it is about wellness, for some it is for treatments, for some it is for the experience. So there are many purposes, and you can see many different methods and styles here